Once again, to be able to worship together online for this service of worship, reflection and prayer. Tonight our theme is our hope being set on God alone, and we'll be hearing later in our service God's word brought to us by Graham. This evening we begin our worship with an opening prayer. Jesus, thank you for your presence with us. We gathered in your name. Help us to be fully present to you in this time, attentive to your word and spirit, alert to one another, joining in this worship online, and make us aware of the needs of the world. As we meet with you, transform us to be more like you. As we see your hope, make us a hopeful people. Amen. Abby, Sue and Dennis are now going to lead us in a time of sun worship.
The reading is Psalm 33. Sing joyfully to the Lord, you righteous. It is fitting for the upright to praise him. Praise the Lord with the harp. Make music to him on the 10-string lyre. Sing to him a new song. Play skillfully and shout for joy. For the word of the Lord is right and true. He is faithful in all he does. The Lord loves righteousness and justice. The earth is full of his unfailing love. By the word of the Lord the heavens were made, their starry host by the breath of his mouth. He gathers the waters of the sea into jars. He puts the deep into storehouses. Let all the earth fear the Lord. Let all the people of the world revere him. For he spoke and it came to be. He commanded and it stood firm. The Lord foils the plans of the nation. He thwarts the purposes of the people. But the plans of the Lord stand firm forever. The purposes of his heart through all generations. Blessed is the nation whose God is the Lord. The people who chose for his inheritance. From heaven the Lord looks down and sees all mankind. From his dwelling place he watches all who live on earth. He who forms the hearts of all, who considers everything that they do. No king is saved by the size of his army. No warriors escape by the great strength. A horse is a vain hope for deliverance. Despite of all its great strength, it cannot save. But the eyes of the Lord on those who fear him, on those who hope is in unfailing love, to deliver them from death and keep them alive in famine. We wait in hope for the Lord. He is our help and our shield. In him our hearts rejoice, for we trust in his holy name. May your unfailing love be with us, Lord, even as we put our hope in you. This is the word of the Lord.
You know, our God is a God of surprises. Way back in the early 1990s, if anyone had said I'd become a Christian, let alone a preacher, let alone an online preacher, I'd have called them absolutely mad. And so my life has been full of surprises. And it was a pleasant surprise that during our current circumstances, when there's so much doom and gloom around, that this Psalm 33, written by an anonymous composer, begins with words of such joyful worship. At this time of such extensive restrictions, we're not permitted to show our own joyful worship to our God. Worship through songs and hymns of praise when we're all together as a fellowship of believers. But don't we, even during the most difficult of times, feel the words of well-known songs or hymns bubbling up within us to the point where they must burst out of our mouths? I know that during the last couple of months, when life has been just a little fraught, and it still is, there have been times when I've suddenly burst out with a song of praise. Most recently, a great song of praise, How Great Thou Art. Maybe some of you will have had the same experience. An experience that immediately lifts us out of the doldrums, helps us to carry on. Now, we don't know the circumstances of the psalmist when he wrote the words and music of Psalm 33. But maybe he and his fellow Jews were also going through tough times. We know they often did. And this was where his way of cheering them up, giving them hope for the future. Although, of course, joyful praise and worship alone, well, it wouldn't have been sufficient for the Jews then or ourselves today to carry on in the midst of troubles. And that's why the psalmist linked those opening verses that encourages singing, praising, worshipping God, with the reason why they should do so. And he does just that in verse 4 and 5 by telling all who would listen then and now that all God's words are right and true. They can be trusted, for God never lies, never forgets, never changes his words, always fulfills his promises. Are we like that? I think I know the answer, but I'm going to leave it as a question mark. But the psalmist wasn't finished. For a further reason for all God's people to joyfully worship and praise God is because of God's all-consuming, unfailing love for his people. His deepest desire for all of his people, for us, is that we be righteous and just, as he is. come on, we might be thinking. God is perfect in all things, including being morally perfect, perfect in righteousness, and always doing the right and just thing. We can't possibly match that, and no, of course we can't. But our God, through our belief and love for his Son, Jesus, our obedience to his ways and words, has graciously declared all of us to be righteous in his sight, even though we're not. So how can we hope not to be set? Such a loving, gracious God. How can we not try at all times to live up to the faithfulness he shows to us? Of course, that's our theme for this online service. Our hope is set on God. What exactly is hope, particularly in terms of our Christian hope in God? Well, Paul tells us in Romans 8, verse 24, hope that is seen is no hope at all. Who hopes for what he already has? If we hope for what we do not yet have, we wait for it patiently. I guess that many of us are praying in the hope of a vaccine to help guard us against COVID-19. But we have no idea when that hope will be realized. But if we wait patiently, confidently, in God's good time, that hope will be realized. And this illustration, I think, speaks very powerfully why we should never give up on hope. We must always be confident that our hope in God will always be fulfilled. I've never seen this painting, but apparently there's a famous painting by someone called G.F. Watt, simply entitled Hope. It pictures a poor woman against the world. Her eyes are bandaged so that she cannot see ahead. In her hands is a harp. All the strings are broken, save one. Those broken strings represent her shattered expectations, her bitter disappointments. That one last unbroken string is the string of hope. She strikes that string and a glorious melody floats out all over the world. It fills her dark skies with stars. The artist painted a great truth. Even when all else is gone, you can still have hope. And I'm sure we can all visualize the scene in that painting. And once again, the truth is, no matter how dire or troubled our lives may become or be, in our God we can be totally confident that there can always be hope in the future. And then the psalmist in verse 6 to 9 tells us why we can have such confident hope in our God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. He offers us a poetic summary of the first chapter of Genesis. Our God is Lord of creation, creator of all that is seen and unseen. He is almighty, all-powerful. He holds all natural, supernatural forces in his almighty hands. And so, as the psalmist says, how can we not revere him, be in total awe of our God, and know that we can have total confidence in our future in and with him? All this is good news for those who believe in and are committed to God. There's bad news for those who work against his moral perfection, who have no belief in Jesus and his ways, who have no experience of Holy Spirit power in their lives. Those who are evil, those who oppress the poor and the vulnerable, those who persecute his people. Let's remind ourselves what the psalmist says in verse 6. The Lord loves righteousness and justice. And then move to verse 10, where he says, the Lord foils the plans of the nations. He thwarts the purposes of the people. You know, I can't think of one country, one nation that totally follows the ways of the Lord our God. Can anyone listen again? Think of one. In most countries, there are what can only be called remnants, pockets of those committed to following the ways of God in Jesus, including our own. Many call themselves Christian countries, but they simply pay lip service to the one they profess to believe in and follow. And so the psalmist proclaims in verse 10 that the plans and purposes of nations and its peoples will be foiled and thwarted. It may not seem so at times. Certainly the peoples of all nations, including our own, may decide that the way their particular country is tackling the current COVID crisis, well, could be handled so much better. But let us be in no doubt. Our God has a plan and a purpose, not only for our nation, but all nations on this earth, for all its peoples, including each one of us. And therein should lie our hope. For as the psalmist says in verse 11, the plans, the purposes of the Lord stand firm forever. Now we need to take note of that little word, all, in verse 13 to 15. It says, the Lord looks down and sees all mankind. He watches all who live on the earth, and he who forms the heart of all considers everything they do. No one can escape his almighty gaze. Nothing any of us do, say, even think is safe from his watchful eye. Pretty scary, isn't it? But the psalmist then goes on. Then it's only those who believe that there is no God looking down on them. Those like great kings who believe that their great strength, power, force, influence will save them from his judgment and wrath. Well, it won't. The psalmist goes on in verse 18, 19 to say that the Lord will look with favour on those who fear him, who revere him, respect him, look with awe upon him. Those whose hope is in his unfailing love, those he will protect and keep safe. Although we all know, of course, that the psalmist wasn't saying that God's people, Christians like ourselves, won't ever face troubles, trauma, illness, persecution, oppression, famine, homelessness, losing our jobs. But whenever we face any one of those, we can be assured, know with absolute certainty that our Lord is with us, giving us the strength, the support, the patience we need to come through those times. And with the total assurance, we can have hope that through his unfailing love, there will always be a future with him, eternal life with him. So where does all that leave us? Well, I hope we can all now have the same belief as the psalmist expresses in the closing verses 20 and 21. We will always wait patiently and in hope for the Lord our God, for he is our help and our shield. Wait in the certain hope that he is always with us, that his strength and support is always with us, that the love of Jesus, Holy Spirit power, is always with us. For as the psalmist says, that hope will lead to our hearts rejoicing, for our trust is always in his holy name. And finally, my hope is that we can all join with the last words of Psalm 33. May your unfailing love rest upon us, O Lord, even as we put our hope in you. And with these words from an anonymous source. The optimist says, my cup is half full. The pessimist says, my cup is half empty. The child of God says, my cup runneth over. Amen.
Lord, Heavenly Father God, we declare to you that we want you to speak to our hearts of that unfailing love every day this week. Amen. The collect prayer for this evening. Almighty God, you called Luke the physician, whose praise was in the gospel, to be an evangelist and physician of a soul. By the grace of the Spirit and through the wholesome medicine of the gospel, give your church the same love and power to heal through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. We'll now share together in a time of prayer.
Praise, honour and glory. May none of God's wonderful works keep silence, night or morning. Bright stars, high mountain, the depths of the sea, sources of rushing rivers, may all these break into song as we praise to the Father, Son and Holy Spirit. May all the angels in heaven reply, Amen, Amen, Amen. Power, praise, honour, eternal glory to God, the only giver of grace. Amen. 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 Dear Lord, in this time of uncertainty due to COVID-19, keep us a place in this land.
Save us a clean stream flowing to unpolluted seas. Lend us the bare earth growing untamed flowers and trees. May we share safe skies when we wake every day with birds and butterflies. Grant us a space where we can play with water, rocks, trees and sand. Lend us forests, rivers, hills and sea. Keep us a place in this land, somewhere to grow, somewhere to be. O Lord, comfort the sick, those that are dying and the elderly. Cover them with your wings and strengthen their hearts that they may continue worshipping you. Help them to find comfort in your word, because in it there is healing and wholeness. In Jesus' name we believe and pray. Amen. Remembering our friends, Janet and Graham Sutherington. Sickness or injury can come to us all, and we feel powerless in the face of them. Lord, bring healing, wholeness of heart, mind and body. Restore strength, renew hope in your mercy, Lord. Deliver us. Amen. Lord, thank you for walking with us through the seasons of our lives, for the winter when we are held safe in your arms, and through the darkness for the hope of spring, as we are filled with a new promise of life, for summertime full of warmth and colour, and for autumn days as leaves fall to seed new growth. You are always with us. Amen. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Just before we sing our final song tonight, I'd just like to make you aware that as a church, St James's now has its own YouTube channel. So if you go to YouTube and you put into the search engine there, St James Church Brown Hills, it should be the top item that appears, and you'll be able to, as weeks go by, watch any material that is placed on there. Later tonight, this service will be put on there, so you'll be able to re-watch Graham's really powerful message that he's brought to us tonight from the Lord. And so, as we enter into this new week, we give all honour and praise to the Lord, because he is the one on whom our hope is set.
Thank you.
Father God, we praise you that you have broken the chains that bound us. You have set us free, Lord, that we may live for you. In Jesus' holy name, amen. A closing prayer. Eternal God, giver of love and power, your Son Jesus Christ has sent us into all the world to preach the gospel of his kingdom. Confirm us in this mission and help us to live the good news that we proclaim through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. A prayer of blessing. May God keep you in all your days. May Christ shield you in all your ways. May the Spirit bring you healing and peace. May God, the Holy Trinity, drive all darkness from you and pour upon you blessing and light. And may the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son and the Holy Spirit be with you now and remain with you forevermore. Amen.